Well-fitting masks offer the best protection against COVID-19, according to the latest CDC guidance. So how do you make sure your mask fits well? We'll find out today. I'm Veronica Rueckert, and this is Badger Talks. Scott Sanders is with us. He is a professor of mechanical engineering and an expert on mask efficiency. Scott, thanks a lot for being here.
Thanks for having me on the show, Veronica.
Well, the CDC released some new guidance about masking, and the takeaway is basically make sure the mask is well fitted, that it's tightly fitted. It's not really a question, of course, anymore of should I wear a mask or shouldn't I? We're past that. We need to wear a mask. We know that. But the question is, a tightly well-fitting mask, what does that look like? And Scott, I know you brought along your example of what a tightly fitting mask looks like. What do you have?
I brought my disposable mask with a badger seal attached to it. This is the mask I wear every day. It's basically an ordinary disposable mask. And then over the top of it, it has this flexible wire that's used to hold the mask better to my face. So I'll put it on here and just goes over my ears. And basically this wire pulls the top and this bottom and the edges against my face and makes it into a very good seal. And so you can see when it does this is when I breathe, you'll see the mask moving in and out. So in and out like that. And that's how we know we have a good fit when we have this mask fitter or the badger seal in this case, sealing the edges of the mask to my face.
Gotcha. And how do we get a hold of one of these, the badger seal?
Yeah, badger seal is more generally, they're called mask fitters. So there's multiple of those around now. The CDC has actually endorsed them as a good option for getting a good fit. And so the badger seal, we have two versions of it. The one is the ear loop version that I just showed. And then the other is called the original, which is slightly different. It actually straps behind your head. So you get a little more pressure to help hold it on. There's pluses and minuses to each. But those are available. The if you just search for mask fitter, you'll see there's at least three companies selling different versions of these things. And a couple of companies locally are selling the Badger Seal, which is the one that was actually invented here on campus back in August.
Terrific. Well, I want to ask you about another option, because this is something we're seeing more of lately. And even Fauci was saying, you know, a double mask might be an option. Now, the CDC is not formally recommending this yet, but it is something people are doing. I guess the idea being two masks are better than one. And the question for me is, how do you effectively double mask? I've got like a typical cloth mask here that I sometimes wear. It's pretty basic. Sometimes we have surgical masks. So how do I do this?
Yeah, and I have a surgical mask here just by itself. It's a disposable mask. This one's not actually medically certified, so it's just kind of the average disposable mask, which is what most people wear, and it's a really good option. But my understanding of the recommendation for double masking would be to wear one of these as normal. So that's like a disposable mask and fit it. And then instead of using the garden tie, which is, of course, not in most people's homes unless they buy the Badger Seal, sometimes a cloth mask over this will kind of have the same effect to help seal the sides and the top of the mask. So if you have a well-fitting cloth mask that you can put over this, it will kind of help seal it up at the edges and the top. And that's really the benefit of double masking. So I view it as if you can't get your hands on the Badger Seal or a mask fitter like I showed earlier, a cloth mask over a ordinary disposable mask might help perform some of the same functionality and get you a little better fit. And it's accessible to more people, because most people would have access to cloth mask as well as a disposable mask.
Now, I want to ask you, UW Health takes the stance that one good mask is better than two masks. So when might you want to move into this double masking situation?
Yeah, I mean, I think of it again as it's just a fallback if you can't get a good fit. The best case is like an N95, where it fits your face really well. And then what we've done with the Badger seal is to try to make a standard disposable mask fit really well like that. And so that's kind of the best. If you can't get that, then the cloth mask would help get some of that capability. And so it's kind of like, to me, it's like a solution that works if you don't have access to a mask fitter. And so it works to a degree. In general, it's not going to work as well as the mask fitter, but it depending on how well the cloth mask fits, it can improve it. And so it's kind of that intermediate solution is what I would say. But I would agree, a single well-fitting mask is really what we should all be after.
Gotcha. Scott, thank you so much for coming on and explaining all this today.
Yeah, my pleasure.
If you have questions for us or topic suggestions or want to comment on this Badger Talk, send us an email at covid19update@uc.wisc.edu. And for more info, you can go to covid19.impact.wisc.edu. This is Badger Talks.